Hello everyone. This video I will show how to create toast notification in Java Swing, and this toast notification I have custom with FlatLaf, so we can apply style custom property, it easy that we using code to custom. I will create in this FlatLaf dashboard project. For this dashboard project, please check my previous video or link I put in description this video for both project, FlatLaf dashboard and this toast notification. Now let's get into my GitHub project here, so we see the sample code here, and we have property that can be used to custom with this project. So what we going to do first, we need to add this library to our project, by just copy jar file in this library folder. Now I has downloaded it and put it in my lib folder, and don't forget to add the FlatLaf library to your project. Because this toast notification I have custom by using FlatLaf code, but this FlatLaf dashboard I have add FlatLaf library ready, so I need add only swing toast notification.jar. Next we going to initialize this toast notification to the JFrame form, by going to the JFrame class. We can write in constructor here by call notifications class, and we see here, it come from my package name. Then call method get instance, and then call method set JFrame, so now pass this JFrame object to this method, we can use this keyword for this current JFrame object. Now it done, so next we going to show toast notification, and we can show notification from any class you want, and it will pop up on the JFrame that we have set. Here we going to form dashboard panel to create notification for test. Create one J button. So in this button event, we just call notifications.getInstance, then call method show. And in method show we have many option, so you can use what you want. Now I use message type and text. For message type we have 4 option, error, info, success and warning. And here we provide the message name. Now we can run the project. Here we got the message has show top center of the screen by default, but we can change the location like left, right or bottom. Now we chain here, by use notification.location. So next we going to custom style, by using FlatLaf style property, so go to the GitHub project. So for another method, we can see here, like show with the custom component. And this for clear the message, for the specific message location, or we can clear all the message. And this for enum message type and the location message. And this the property file. Now I will show you how to change the notification background color. So we can copy this sample code here, and go to the FlatLaf file property that I have create ready in this FlatLaf dashboard. We use this background property in FlatLaf.property because we need to use this style to both, dark themes and light themes. And this property for outline width, so copy it. So we see the outline border here. And more property here that we can use in FlatLaf file property, like we can set the duration. Horizontal gap. Or arc, for round border. This for shadow color. Use effect, the use effect by default has true, so now I show how to disable use effect on the light mode. So go to flatlight.property and add use effect property to false to disable. So here when it dark mode, it's showing effect, but when I switch to light mode, now it no effect color here. And for more property you can check here, I cannot show you all, so let try and test it yourself, and for more property I will update and push to this repo. And this for change the default icon, by easy way, we use it with UI Manager class with flat SVG icon class, so now copy this sample code. Go to the main method in main JFrame class where you set up the look and feel. So here the place that we use this code. We can use the Toast client properties class instance here, for the property name like close callback, close icon, error icon, and another property that available in class. And this for the property value, so we use the flat SVG icon to create the icon, so now change the this path to your path location. Now copy the SVG icon that you want to change. So here we custom the error icon, so now go to change the message type to error message. And for the property we use toast error icon. If the icon so big, we can scale it to small. So next we're going to change the default color, success color, error color, info and warning color. So now go to the testing code in this project to copy the code that I have right in FlatLaf file property. And here we have different color style between light mode and dark mode, so this for light mode, so now copy it to the flatlight.property. This for dark mode, copy this to flatdark.property. Here I need to remove the outline width, because I don't want it. So now the color has applied to this toast notification. When we change the theme's code and message type, we will see the different color. Now I remove this sample code. You can use if you need, but for me I use the default icon. For more property or style that you want to have in this toast notification custom, let comment in this video below. I will try to update if I can, and don't forget to follow up this project on GitHub for new update. And finally, I am thank you to all of you have watched my video from the start to the end of the video. Thank you and see you next video.